Have you been arrested? Have you ever been thrown in the back of the paddy wagon? The Hooskow got the, Josh, we call it silver bracelets. Silver bracelets.
Yes.
I take it no one in this room has ever felt the cold iron around their wrists as being led to a squad car?
No.
Well.
Oh, dear. Story.
No, I've never been arrested.
Never?
I mean, I've come close. I mean, let's be honest. But thankfully, no.
I was taken to a squad car in 1997. Would I call it an arrest? Maybe in an exaggerated tale over a fire with friends. But my Frostburg City Police Department, 1997, September 14th. You could look it up on MDK search. Skateboarding in public. It was a $50 fine. You can see the...
Where are we at with that?
There's the charges right there.
Is that like area by area, case by case?
Yeah.
It's still just kind of...
It's gotten better, but I mean, it's still trespassing. Trespassing's trespassing.
But that's a cool trespassing.
It's kind of badass, right?
It's like, God.
You want to throw
up? I get like maybe if you're grinding on stuff, you know...
If I'm ruining property.
Jacking up some property and stuff. But like, man, oh, let the kids express themselves.
Dude, it has...
It's a good, fun outlet.
It has my weight on here at the time.
What? Let me see. What is it?
It's absurd. Very top. I'll tell you right now, I weigh 194.
You probably weighed 130 back then.
It's like 135. It's like you looked it up already.
Yeah, I
can.
That's
amazing.
135. 5 pounds off.
I haven't gotten any taller. Still 5'9". Eyes brown, soul black. 410-338-1098. All right, we're going to fly blind on a few of these calls here. We did get a few tweets in here. Rodney, thought I knew you. McCribbles writes, yes, first-degree assault, second-degree assault, failure to obey, destruction of property, yikes, trespassing, and conspiracy to all of
these. That's what you call a bad night.
That's a bad boy. Got a bad daddy on our hands. Line one, good morning. Who's this?
Hey, it's Dolly. What's up, y'all?
Hey, Dolly.
I knew you.
Of course you've been arrested, you son of a bitch.
Back of a cruiser. What'd you do?
All right, so I've only been... I've been in the holding cells and let go of my own recognizance, but four times in my life did I get the pleasure of having the handcuffs and escorted to the vacation house for the weekend.
Yeah. What was the
so
most...
What's
the most egregious? Just give us the most serious, the big one.
The biggest one? I can't really say there was a big one. I got the most recent one was I got arrested for supposedly DUI, but I beat all the charges.
Oh, good for you.
Okay,
man.
There you go.
Supposedly, I was getting my Timberlake on, and the next thing you know, I was like, dude, I ain't even trashed. Am I buzz? Of course. But I ain't even trashed, dude. I was trying to drive in both lanes so I could get myself some space.
Yeah, how many of those are we going to get? I was arrested, but look.
Dude,
hey, look.
Dude.
But look.
Straight up,
know,
dude. Can I be honest with you for real?
They got me hemmed up. I ain't do nothing.
I love the term hemmed up. Hell yeah. Oh, yeah. Like you're taken to some sort of legal seamstress. 410-338-1098. The phones are filling up. We're going to get your calls, read your texts and tweets after sports with Val. Why the hell did you get arrested? What did you do after sports? Why the hell did you get arrested? What the hell happened? Okay. 410-338-1098. Our pal Ralph, I'm glad you're on the up and up, man. Whenever I see my friend Ralph now, he is doing well, looking fine, got all those teeth replaced. He says, I was arrested for possession with intent, heroin, possession, weed, possession, paraphernalia, possession, paraphernalia, not a weed type. All of his were drug related.
Yeah.
But he's doing good these days. We see Ralph every now and then. He's always got a big smile on his face. Only thing he gets drunk on these days is a good Cobb salad and a good night's sleep. 410-338-1098. Let's go to the phones. Talk to our old pal, Trucker Mike. What the hell did you get arrested for?
Morning, boys.
Morning.
So back in high school, I was dumb. Someone dared me to do it. I pulled the fire alarm. I threatened to blow up the school in 666. And I was arrested and sent up to the detention center in Westminster. And I had to spend a night up there.
Wow, you pulled the fire alarm. And you threatened to blow up the school? Did a double?
Yes, I did.
Wow.
And did I hear something about 666? Did you do this in celebration of the Dark Lord Satan?
Yes, I did.
Fantastic. Always love hearing from Satanist Mike. Let's head to the phones and talk to someone else from the wrong side of the tracks. Let's go to Philip. Philip, good morning. Why were you arrested?
Morning.
Morning.
Just minding my own business, driving down the road one night, had a tail light out, and they decided to pull me over. And I just wanted to see how fast their cop car would go.
You wanted
you
to see.
Took off, dude.
You're so stupid.
You made life so much worse for yourself.
Yeah, well, young, you know.
How old?
And I was probably 20.
Okay, that's way too old to go and test the capabilities of a police cruiser.
Well, because I watched that Friday, Saturday nights, that On Patrol live show, and there's a lot of times where they're like, bro, I was just going to write you a taillight ticket.
Yeah.
Now that you took off, you've got fleeing from police, evading, resisting arrest, the charges.
Reckless driving.
Oh, my God. Like, they just pile them on.
I would have told you, hey, get that fixed.
Yeah.
Looking out for you. And now, what do they say, three hots and a cot? How long did it take them to catch up to you? And what were you driving?
Yeah.
I was driving a 69 Pontiac. And back then, they had...
A Firebird?
Like Catalina. Big Bonneville car. 455.
Pontiac Bonneville. 69.
69 Catalina. Look at this land whale. Look at the size. Of a 69 Catalina. You weren't outrunning nothing.
Oh, I like the front of that.
Oh, the thing is slick as hell. Tell me Quentin Tarantino doesn't have one of those in his garage. So what were the amount of charges? What did you get? You had to have get resisting arrest, reckless driving.
Looting, reckless, speeding. Let's see. Oh, the car wasn't registered. In my name.
Damn. Oh, God, you're so dumb.
Did you have a license?
I had a license.
Hey, actually, there we go. Good for you. You weren't riding dirty. I'm proud of you. Thank you for the call, Philip. I love your seafood restaurant. Let's go to Brandon on line four.
Brandon.
Hi. Hey, can I just say real quick how extremely happy I am for you, Justin?
Thank you, Brandon.
So happy.
You sent me a very nice message yesterday. Thank you for that.
Tomorrow night, Justin will be on the Bert Kreischer Comedy Festival tour.
While everybody's parking, I'll be on stage.
Get there early.
Please.
Brandon. Mm-hmm. Brandon. Yep. Mischief. Really, Brandon? What'd you get arrested for?
So I fought my uncle. So my uncle was staying with me. I got we got in a fizz alt because he was in between efficiencies. So he was staying with me, and it's my Uncle Juniper. Mm-hmm. And let me just preface this by saying everyone knows how much I love Pillsbury Toaster Strudels. I think we all know that. But
to a Pop-Tart. I know. They're kind of apples and oranges to me, but a Toaster Strudel is pretty good.
If you have more time, Toaster Strudel, grab and go Pop-Tart.
Well, I go to the freezer, and what do you know? Three strudels, no icings. So, you know, I freak out because his strudel to icing ratio is 3-1, which is crazy. So, I go to the walk-in closet he's sleeping in, grab him by his rat tail, and the fight ensued. Fight broke out. We both get arrested. But here's the kicker. You want to know the kicker?
What's the kicker?
He owed me icing restitution.
Icing ratio. Oh, 3-1. He liked him Peter North style.
That bastard.
Oh, my God. Thank you, Brandon. Jesus, that's funny. Jamie.
I always find that one icing packet enough?
If I can piggyback, one spice bag and a bag of ramen's never enough. I go two bags. And I always leave one pack out in the cold. There's one bundle of dry ramen.
That's right.
And because I like to double up the spice, they call me double bag. And yes, the amount of strudel icing they give you.
Never seems like it's enough.
Never enough. Jamie, what'd you get arrested for?
Yes. Didn't quite get arrested, but when I was about 8 years old in a little town in Greensboro, Maryland, the sheriff's coming to my parents' house. I was a kid that got into stuff back in the day.
Yeah.
So the sheriff's questioning me on, there's a March of Dimes can missing from the little convenience store called Bodie's. It was the corner store in that little thing. Somebody lifted the March of Dimes donation can.
Right.
So he questioned me about it. It had nothing to do with it.
Who did it? You know who did it?
Never did it. 5 years ago, I bought another house in the town of Greensboro, Maryland. I started renovating it. I went down to the bottom floor, bedroom, child's room.
Okay.
And I start tearing the walls out. Get to the closet. Guess what falls out of the closet?
The March of Dimes can?
Shut up. Shut up.
No way.
Shut up, Jamie.
Whose house was it? Do you know whose house it was?
Jamie, shut up.
I went to a town historical meeting with
yeah,
a story.
Yeah, shut
and,
up.
They were researching the owner of the house, but they didn't take it any further than that. They
no, know I don't care. I mean, I'm just curious. Maybe you know the kid that lived in that house or something?
Just,
he said it was a right, small town.
Just curious, in Greensboro, is that Dorchester County?
That's Caroline County.
Yeah, that's what I said.
Yeah, okay,
that's what I said. How dare you?
That's crazy.
Contradict
he
me.
Found the March of Dimes
cop
that he was interrogated
shut
about. Oh, you know.
Shut up.
Yeah, your whore mouth.
Shut the up.